Hare Krishna. Seek first to understand the question, to best understand the answer. Suppose we join a talk, and we join a talk, maybe it's a question answer talk, or the talk is over and the question answers are going on, and then we join and try to make sense of what the speaker is speaking. If the speaker were answering a particular question, or if the whole talk had started because of a particular question, and then the talk is going deep into various subjects to answer that question, then understanding the question would help us make sense of the talk. Otherwise, we feel the talk is wandering all over the place. So similarly, when we study the Bhagavad Gita, it's important for us to understand what the Gita's driving question is. Then we can understand the overall context in which the content of the Gita is spoken. Without that driving question, sometimes the Bhagavad Gita can seem quite complex and even incoherent. Now, so what is the driving question of the Bhagavad Gita? In 2.7, when Arjun surrenders to Krishna, at that time he asks the question, Karpanya dosho pahata swabhava prichhami tvam dharma sammoodha chetaha yashreyasya nishchitam bruhi tanme shishyaste ham shadhimam tvam prapannam. So Krishna is saying, Krishna is being told by Arjun, Prichhami tvam, I am asking you, what? Dharma sammoodha chetaha, I am asking you, what is my dharma? Sammoodha chetaha, I am bewildered. So the whole Bhagavad Gita's driving question is, what is dharma? Now dharma refers not just to religion or even duty. Dharma refers fundamentally to the action that sustains our existence. Dharma refers to that course of action which harmonizes us with our nature and the nature of reality. So Arjun's question is universal. Although the Bhagavad Gita is spoken before a battle, and although it may seem to be a discussion about whether Arjun should fight or not, but that is not the driving question. Arjun is not asking Krishna, should I fight or not? And that's why we will see in the subsequent content of the Gita, Krishna does not talk anything about the specific atrocities that the Kauravas had performed, and the specific reasons why the Pandavas should fight against the Kauravas. Krishna speaks about dharma, the right course of action. And all the analysis of the various yogas, the various understandings of the absolute truth, all this is given in the Gita to help us understand what is our dharma. And that question, how are we meant to act in our life? That is a universal question. Everybody faces this sometime or the other in life. Actually, we face it at every moment. But most of the times in our life, we more or less act according to our programming. So, I have to do a job, I have to take care of my family, I have to study the subject. But there are times when life brings us to perplexities, and then we start thinking, okay, everything is temporary, everything is going to be lost. What really counts? What am I actually living for? And then, that is when the Bhagavad Gita's message resonates most with us. So the Bhagavad Gita answers by telling, whatever we act, the right course of action is to act with love. Act in the mood of loving service to the divine and to all living beings in relationship with the divine. And it is because the Gita's driving question is universal that its message has resonated with people, with millions of people for millennia. The Bhagavad Gita is not at all a book that is talking about violence. It is talking about dharma, the path to inner harmony and outer harmony. The path that can take all of all people at all places towards ultimate satisfaction. So when we keep this driving purpose of the Gita in mind, then its various pieces, its various sections fall into place, and the Bhagavad Gita becomes eminently coherent and eminently relevant for us. Thank you. Hare Krishna.